Hello, everybody. My name is Deborah Nicholson-Bassham, and I built NoodleBrain.com back in the year 2000. And this is the integrity tone scale section, which I don't know why, but you can't reach, even though it's built in Flash, which is a super, super secure page. So I'm going to walk you through it so that you can learn about the integrity tone scale, which was started in 1978 by two doctors in San Francisco. So I'm going to read it and walk you through it. We assert that nowhere in our public interest conversations, not in education, and certainly not in the mass media of our mainstream newspapers, nor in our television viewing, do we find public guidance on how to operate powerfully with an inner trust that we can reach the goals we have for ourselves, for our families, for our communities, for our country, and for our planet as a whole. We need this to grow strong and to get along. Operating powerfully in trust functions as a condition of one's ability to be true to him or herself and is conditionally based on one's state of integrity. So we want to empower others by offering the distinction of integrity as something doable and necessary to turn this world on its ear and bring back a civilization that cares about its people. The Integrity Tone Scale was copyrighted by Vern Black and David B. Goodstein in August 1978 and is a useful learning tool to assess the state of our integrity and the integrity of others in a particular instance or in our relationships in general. This tool is crucial for evicting the current mindset generated by television programming and current events that send us all to the pits, which is down here in number 16. The Integrity Tone Scale presents the setting and the guideposts needed to propel us forward towards normal, which is over here at number 3, the state in which we were born. Though normal may be the highest state of integrity we would happily claim, given our collateral TV damage, the Integrity Tone Scale goes beyond that state for those of us with more ambition. Being a power source, number 1, in our lives and in our community is not impossible using this roadmap where we generate the internal conversations that empower us to make contributions that make a difference in the quality of our lives and the lives of those we love. Because it is in our human nature to naturally want to serve, and it is in our animal nature to be divine in that service, making a difference generates its own reward. When we put on our paradoxical lenses, we can see the thing that keeps us trapped in lower states of integrity. Without knowledge of the secular measures for the building of principles and values that allow connectivity to occur, we tend to default to religions to fulfill our spiritual need for connection. Unfortunately, religion tends to prohibit our ability to get along with others who are not of our faith, so it doesn't work well for creating a civilization of multiculturalism and connection. To break out of the stupidity of nationalism and patriotism, where we actually do use religious differences as a means for justifying war to capture lands and resources, we need a secular way to build principles and values that can assure us of a strong and diverse world community. When we are appreciative and respectful of differences, we can share our skills and resources powerfully. Through commerce, necessarily grounded in enlightened business practices. Otherwise, we fall into the traps that keep crime, war, or disease in place. We offer our bodies, our minds, our hearts, our spirits up to the system that will entrap us to make a buck. And if you look, those who are successful in this world, at best, win approval to buy a house with a huge debt that does not go away when it is time for our children to inherit. This is a sad state, but it is also stupid. What can you learn from this module? You will learn to assess the particular state of integrity you are currently in when considering your emotional tone, your attitude, the problem you are recognizing and relating to others, and the roles others are playing regarding the state of integrity you are operating out of with them. You will also learn what it takes to get up and out of this particular state of integrity so that you can move on and enhance your life. There are 16 different states of integrity. This module begins at power source, number one, buttons on the left, and moves down to the lowest level, of the pits, number 16, bottom on the right. At the disloyalty band, six. They say that 85% of the population lives in disloyalty with itself. And if you look at that band, you can see why. As long as we are focused on using bodies in one way or another to relate to others, we will feel betrayed and want to relate with revenge. If we want to move up to the state in which we were born, the state called normal over here, we have a lot of work to do. And of course, being at the top of the scale is the goal. Being a power source for games, serenity of beingness and action, something we think is only reserved for the rich, but not so. When we use this integrity tone scale to track our emotional tones and attitudes about things, we notice that our relationships with others become more productive, more honest, more satisfying. We discover that sadly, we have been living predictable lives programmed by our own impulses to imitate behavior we see on TV because we had a belief that TV actually represented all that there is. Now we know that TV really keeps us bound in sorrowful, guilt-ridden behaviors out for revenge or demonstrating hatred and anger. We can dislodge from that programming and begin to get psychologically healthy again by allowing ourselves to move up this scale. By the way, you can still watch TV when you finish the Integrity Tone Scale. You'll just be a little smarter not to get hooked in behaving ways that are imitative. We discover that detriment responsible, this area here, behavior is actually very high space to be in, considering most people hang out in the pits down here. Moving into non-existence, number six, is a gift. Danger, number five, is only two steps down from normal, and emergency, number four, is actually where challenges and cooperation from others comes into play. We have been so duped to believe a lot of horrible things about human beings, and we at Noodle Brain assert that this just isn't so. But you have to be on a path to know the distinctions needed to get out of the pits. Coming from abundance, number two, does not necessarily mean having a lot of money, although it can. It means that we have a cheerfulness, an enthusiasm for life that cannot be extinguished by pitiful others. It means that you welcome new things into your life and others are devoted to you and what you are up to. Nice place to be in if you can commit. This is the first state. We're starting at the bottom of the integrity tone scale here. This is band number six, the pits. And the reason why it's the pits, you will soon see. So people who made this scale started with a context of each state of integrity and the name of the state of integrity and then the emotional tone of this state of integrity when you're in it. So the emotional tone in disloyalty band six is, or in any of these bands, or how you were feeling when you stand in this state of integrity. So as you move forward, these boxes will stay the same. The attitude means your position, what compels you to act. The problem recognition is how you see the problem facing you in each different level of integrity. And the recognitions of others' roles is how you see how others interact with you when you're in this state of integrity. And how to move up is advice from the creators of the Integrity Tone Scale. What to do? Do this to start moving up the scale to normal. So in band six, disloyalty band number six, the pits, the emotional tone is useless, dying, body death, failure, pity, regret, accountable, blame, shame, controlling bodies, protecting bodies, owning bodies, approval from bodies, needing bodies, worshiping bodies, sacrifice, hiding, being objects, being nothing, can't hide, total failure. That is how you feel emotionally when you're in disloyalty band 6. Your attitude is ruin, self-pity, blame, shame, condemned, greed, jealous, malice, anguish, and nothing. You feel like nothing. Your attitude is nothing. You're nothing. The problem recognition is you see others, you see life as betrayal. You are being betrayed in this lifetime when you're in disloyalty band 6. That is your context for being. And your recognition of others' roles is revenge. People are out to get you. Maybe you're out to get them. How to move up and move out of this state of integrity, which is a very, very unhealthy state of integrity to be in, is the first step is you decide to trust yourself. All right, kind of hard. You've been really evil lately. But just the same, you have to decide to trust yourself. You have to tell the truth about your experience, even if you're just talking into the mirror or meditating. And you have to start writing a journal where you list the decision to trust yourself, and then you go about learning how to do that. When you're ready, you move up to the next level of integrity. Oh, well, actually, before we do, we have a little statement here. In this statement of integrity, we are at war with ourselves and with others. This is an unhealthy state of integrity to be in. We recommend that a job or a relationship that causes us this kind of pain be ditched ASAP. Be aware that attachment keeps us in this lowest state of integrity. To get out, we recommend meditation to detach from the thoughts that keep us stuck here. Meditation is easy. Find yourself a quiet place where you can sit comfortably, close your eyes, observe and follow your natural breath rising from your throat until it arises from your lower belly. This may take some time, 40 minutes. If that doesn't work, get a coach, go to the gym, or accomplish a small goal. But get out of the job, the relationship, whatever is keeping us here, and detach so we can have a life. Make a decision to trust ourselves, to have compassion and forgiveness for ourselves and others, and then pull through to the next level. We're going to continue this with disloyalty band 5. Now we're in disloyalty band 5. The state of integrity is disloyalty band 5. The emotional tone here, surprisingly, is apathy. You really don't care. You just don't care about anything. You want to know what apathy means? Google it. Attitude is your position. What compels you to act is apathy, meaning you're not going anywhere fast. You're just in a state of, I don't care. Problem recognition is you're totally overwhelmed. You're just overwhelmed by the possibility that you are a bad, evil person, and you don't deserve to live, and nobody's ever going to love you, and you just have nothing to offer. The recognition of other roles is surrender. You can see that the only thing people around you really want you to do is to surrender. They all surrender to this evilness in your eyes. How to move up? Again, decide to trust yourself, tell the truth about your experience, list the decision to trust yourself, get out your journal, and start writing all about who you're apathetic, and make it like conscious stream journal. Don't plan it or write it or outline it. Just start writing and write about apathy, your own apathy, the apathy of others. Just keep writing until you stop writing. Next, we're going to move to disloyalty band 4. Oh, now we're moving to 5. Oh, right, we have a comment about 5. Sorry, I haven't been here for a while, so I made this in 2000, but I really see the need for it today, in 2020. That's 20 years now. In disloyalty band 5, in this state of integrity, we feel kind of numb and lost, given we just got out of the pits. Our minds are not picking on us yet. Our minds are not picking on us anymore. And we are looking for someone or something to surrender to, but we are too overwhelmed to ever dare to allow someone that kind of trust. So we become apathetic. We drop out and we do not participate It is good to pause here for a moment and recognize the space we are in. Acceptance will move us up the scale. Yeah, you have to accept that you're apathetic. Again, we got to decide to trust ourselves. Use forgiveness and compassion if necessary and tell the truth about our experience, at least to ourselves. We're going to move up to disloyalty band 4 right now. And in this state of integrity, the emotional tone is grief, making amends, underserving, undeserving, self-abasement, victim, and hopeless. Yeah, unfortunately, you do have to go through these stages and you do have to face the possibility of feeling these feelings to get well again. So allow yourself to grieve, think about making amends, start writing in your journal, how would I do it, and why do I feel undeserving, and notice how self-abasement, that means that you're insulting yourself. You feel victimized, you feel hopeless. Your attitude is grief, remorse, making amends. Nobody's going to help you, and there is no hope. But this is perfect. This is a perfect place to be right now in this loyalty band 4. You are processing. The problem recognition is there's a huge burden for you to be going through this. So you just have to acknowledge it. You have to recognize that you have a burden that you have to work through. And recognition of others' roles is solace. If you get solace from anyone, you will get some help. There may not be anyone, so you're going to have to give yourself some solace. Google what solace means. Watch some videos of what solace is like so that you have some understanding of what that means. You are on a path now. How to move up? Again, decide to trust yourself, tell the truth about your experience, list the decision to trust yourself. That really means write a lot in your journal about this state of integrity. And then, moving up the scale may not be fun for our ego, but it develops the spirit necessary to break out of the mindsets produced by TV, bad films, and the triggered behaviors that got us here in the first place. This is a healthy place to be, considering where we have come from. It hurts to feel like a burden to others and to seek solace, and it really bites when we can't get any help from anyone else. Thankfully, we've got ourselves. Grieve our grief, feel our feelings honestly, accept that we may not have any help, and it feels like no hope, and trust ourselves to pull through, and we will pop out of here. Moving along to disloyalty band 3, the emotional tone at disloyalty band 3 is numb, sympathy, appropriation. Look up those words if you don't know what it means. Your attitude is loneliness, yearning, sympathy, propitiation, despondency, numbness. Your problem is you're trapped. You feel like you're trapped, like this person in the sea. And your recognition of others' roles is rescue. You want to be rescued, for sure. Again, how to move up? Decide to trust yourself. These are all the same in the disloyalty bands. Decide to trust yourself. Tell the truth about your experience in your journal. Don't talk to other people. It's important to do it in your journal where it's private. List the decision to trust yourself. Then we move to what it's like being in disloyalty band 3. Ugh, trapped in a sea of nothingness, looking to be rescued from the seemingly never-ending babbling of our inner voice makes us wonder why no one is there for us. We feel lonely and begin to feel the edges of our clueless state of being. If only someone would rescue us. We think we can get out of this mind trap, but it is just another passage for the development of self-trust, self-concept, self-worth. Keep reinventing that we are trustworthy, that we are beyond the small thoughts in our heads. We bar recycled trash from this stupid environment, and that is metaphorical. All the crap that we've been attached to, we just bar it, and we don't keep recycling the words in our heads that make us feel bad. recognize our desire for connection, and keep trusting ourselves, and we move on. Disloyalty band two. Oh, disloyalty is so hard to swim through. The emotional tone here is fear, despair, and terror. Look at these ugly devils. They got your ass. Yep. And your attitude is apprehension, fear, dread, worry. Look up these words. Google these words. Look up these words if you do not know what they mean. Problem recognition here is you feel threatened. Your life is being threatened. It does feel like you're being threatened when you're in fear and despair and terror. It's pretty scary. And the recognition of other roles are protection. You just want to be protected by other people. And at this point, there really isn't anyone there but you. And so protect yourself. How to move up? Once again, decide to trust yourself. Tell the truth about your experience. List the decision to trust yourself. Write in your journal. Keep this information private. Write in your journal. Don't write online. Don't keep a journal online. Just buy a book, a blank book, and start writing. Hang on now. This is a scary place to be, and most people go to religion instead of developing that inner core that does not fear, but moves beyond the shadow of doubt, where we needn't fear any evil because we are conquering the source of fear, our inner demons. Because we are conquering the source of fear, our inner demons. Because we are conquering the source of fear, our inner demons, as we move through this integrity tone scale. We may be worried, threatened, and crave protection. But the protection we are seeking is from our own internal critic, or thought police, programmed into us since birth with ideas of original sin, etc. We gotta trust ourselves, tell the truth to ourselves and to others, and keep on trucking past this scary and illusory dude. Ah, finally, disloyalty band one. The emotional tone and disloyalty band one, the top of the disloyalty band. And when you move from this, you move someplace else. In this place, you feel resentment. Your emotional tone is resentment. No sympathy for anyone but yourself. Unexpressed resentment, so you're holding on to it. You're not telling anybody. You're just holding on to it. And you have covert hostility toward others. Write it in your journal. Let it out. You will enjoy this later. Just write it in your journal. Free form. Just consciousness writing. Just let it go. Your attitude is humiliation, resentment, petulance, sullenness, and suspicion. If you don't know what those words mean, look it up. The problem recognition is there's a conspiracy. You know there's a conspiracy against you. And the recognition of others' roles is stealth, meaning they're hiding everything from you. How to move up? Decide to trust yourself. Tell the truth about your experience. List the decision to trust yourself. This is the last stage of being disloyal to ourselves. After having gone through so much Minecraft to get here, we tend to get a little pissed that we were in disloyalty in the first place. We begin to wonder, what is this crap all about? Who made it this way? How will it end? There seems to be some kind of conspiracy as people appear to demonstrate stealth, escape observation. The ability to deal with ambiguity is a function of mental health. In this paradoxical place, we will find ourselves all over the map with our feelings and thoughts before we decide to once again trust ourselves to go for results. Invent some cool goals and keep trucking. Now we move into the adversary band, which is the second band in the integrity tone scale. The emotional tone here is anger and hate. Yeah, write it out in your journal. Don't share it with other people. Be private about who you are. You're building your own armor so that you can have an objective reality and a subjective reality that actually acts and predicates its behavior on intention. So write up, why are you angry? Who do you hate? Don't hold anything back. Your attitude is arrogance, which is the fear of being judged and found wanting. conceit, I am better than other people, and contempt, I'll get you, you little whatever. The problem recognition is you're insulted. You've been terribly insulted by life. And how you recognize other people is you've been dominated by people all your life. Maybe not really, but it feels like you've been dominated by people all your life because you haven't really taken a stand to be who you totally are. But get it out. Write it all out. In this section, we finally have a different way to move up. Recognize your opposition to results. Discover your positions and their payoffs. Choose to play for results. Now, what I would recognize and ask you to do in this section is start either a new journal or make a tab on your journal page and start writing. Recognizing what your opposition is to getting results. What's in your way? And write out what your positions and their payoffs are. Why do you stay where you are? And what payoff do you get out of it? And then choose to play results. If I were going to play for results, I would write it out. This state of integrity signals the first taste of getting our power back. We're not exactly happy campers, but a shift has occurred, and we are no longer blaming ourselves for what goes on in our life and in our world. But neither are we really yet equipped for being a power source of anything yet. No, this is where we begin to hold others responsible for our problems, but without throwing ourselves in the trash can as well. Arrogance is the fear of being judged and found wanting. So we need to be easy on ourselves and on others. We need to keep on moving up and choose to get results. We don't wallow here for too long. As you can see, we have a little brat giving you the finger and some sexy bitch in the background egging you on. You don't really want to be there. Keep moving. Now we're finally at adversary band number one. Luckily, there's only two adversary bands. In this emotional tone, you feel antagonism, hostility, and a lot of pain. Now, keep in mind, you can go through these integrity tone scale, 16 levels of integrity, very quickly and not get a whole lot out of it. Or you can go very, very slowly and just let it be a part of your day. You're going to get a lot of awareness out of this. Don't be afraid. Your emotional tone, like I said, is antagonism. You're going to be antagonized by all the horrible things you ever did and all the horrible things that you had to live through. And you're going to feel really hostile and you're going to feel a lot of pain. So you want to cry a lot. You want to meditate a lot. Your attitude is going to be defiance, shock, outrage, and reasonableness. And you're going to feel these, you're going to have this attitude because at some point you're going to start recognizing that maybe it's not your fault. Your problem recognition is attack. You just want to attack others. I believe that's what it means. And your recognition of others is they want to suppress you. They really don't want to hear what you have to say. That's why I'm asking you to put all this in a journal so you don't have to suffer the consequences of having to deal with people later. How to move up. Again, recognize your opposition to results, discover your positions and their payoffs, choose to play for results. This is not going to cost you anything going through this. This is not major therapy that costs $80 an hour or $125 an hour. This is not going to expose your personality to being downgraded in the work world. If you do this process privately, and give yourself some time to work it through. Buy a wiffle bat and some strong pillows you can beat the F out of. That will help you a lot. That is how I was put through this. So do it. Okay. Now that we're holding other people responsible for the conditions we live in, by the way, when I said that is how I went through this, I actually went through the therapy. I did do the pounding. I did so many theater workshops to express myself. I've really done a lot of work. I must have spent $50,000 on therapy, and then I created this. If you do this, you won't have to do thousands and thousands of dollars in therapy, and you won't have to have your name degraded in any way. So now that we are holding other people responsible for the conditions we live in, instead of ourselves, we will probably start to attack when we feel antagonism, hostility, and pain coming at us from the outside. We feel others are trying to suppress us rather than give us reasons for the things that are shocking us. Although this state of integrity is not going to win us friends nor influence people, it is still an important state to pass through, because until we come to terms with taking responsibility for what we let others do to us, our naivety will outrage us. Our demand for reasons will not always be heard or acknowledged. This can make us mean. Most people stuff it and pretend it is all okay. We don't. We choose. And then by choosing, we move up to a better state of integrity. We now move into uncertainty. In this state of integrity, uncertainty, our emotional tone is bored. Life is boring. Life is monotonous. All that drama that you just lived through is easing up. Your attitude is annoyance, vexation, exasperation. It's different. It's really different. Your problem recognition is infringement. You feel like anybody that asks you to do anything is kind of infringing on your private space. And the recognition of others' roles is they're evading you and deflecting the thing from you, the things that you need to know. How to move up, you have to choose. At last, we are out of the blaming state of integrity. This is where our relentless ego begins to yield to our growing spirit. So what happens to us when we are uncertain but not stopped? Things seem to move real slow. We easily get annoyed with others because they may be stuck in lower states of integrity, or maybe they are further along and seem to evade or deflect our insatiable need to know. It is exasperating when we finally produce results and discover we need more information to attempt certainty. We need to get over it. To get to the exciting side of mastery, we just choose and discover things for ourselves. Detriment responsible. Detriment responsible. Our emotional tone is disinterest and guilt. So we don't care, we don't want to care, and we feel guilty about not caring. Our attitude is disappointment, disinterest, reluctance, self-consciousness, feeling wrong, indifference, boredom. All those come up. And we let them come and go, come and go. Meditation, that's how you kind of observe. What you really do in meditation is just observe your breath and thoughts arise. And as soon as thoughts arise, you put them in a cloud and let them drift away, and you go back to your breath. And the more you do that, the less the mind will interject with its point of view. But believe me, when you start in meditation, you've got to constantly come back to your breath. You constantly have to let go of things. You just have to keep breathing through, I recommend 40 minutes of sitting cross-legged with your sitting bones, the bones in the back of your butt, on a pillow, and your knees cross-legged, resting on the floor. Your attitude is disappointment, disinterest, reluctance, self-consciousness, feeling wrong, indifference, boredom. You feel obligated. That's your problem recognition. You just are obligated. You must push forward, which is really a good thing. And the recognition of others is you're willing to endeavor, assist, and agree with them. That's a big, big step. How to move up, clean up any damage that you created in the past, list your valuableness, acknowledge your ability to trust and be trusted, and serve others. Serving others really works well with learning humility and watching your ego rise and not want to serve others and only want to serve yourself. You know, there's like this place of transition that when serving others, it really gives you an opportunity to make a difference elsewhere. And that's where you start to realize your value. So it's a really good idea to go through this step. This state of integrity is grueling, but definitely worth its salt in personal development. We have moved past uncertainty, and what we now know isn't all that great. It is not the pits, But disappointment, disinterest, and guilt over being disinterested sets in at this point and makes our participation a detriment. But we are still willing to be responsible. By the way, being responsible means being willing to be cause in the matter. We are obligated to be present. This might be likened to doing duty in the army. At peace, we advise to stay committed to our path and to acquire an attitude of service to pull through. Help your mom. Help your brother, your sister. Help your neighbor. Go volunteer your services at some old age center or at some hospital. Service. At war, we advise conscientious objection. When I don't know who I am, I serve you. When I know who I am you. Homicide sucks. Don't kill people. Non-existence. This might be the first time you start to feel good about yourself. The emotional tone in non-existence is contented. The attitude is distant. You don't really feel that close to all that noise anymore. You're just content. The problem recognition is you feel separated, but oh my God, it's so nice to be separate from others. It's nice to have an entity I can call my own and see the difference between me as a subject and me as an object in other people's eyes. The recognition of others' roles is unimportant at this point. In non-existence, you get to be important. How to move up? Make a goal of support about goal. Locate channels of communication. Find people to interact with where you can use your language skills, preferably in a service position, like volunteer position, where you can stay on point about the purpose of the volunteer work that you're doing and just leave you out of the conversation. You're just contributing and learning how to contribute in a situation that needs you. This builds valuableness. Communicate to make yourself known, find out what is needed or wanted, and start doing it. We all know those rare moments when we feel content. We don't really care that we feel separated from others. They are unimportant at this level. We don't care that we do not exist in their world. We know we exist in ours. We are producing results, and we are beginning to make a difference in what we say and what we do. We would like to hover here and not move on. Just 86 the rest of the world and rest. This euphoria cannot last. Eventually, we realize that no man or woman is an island. We are nothing without the other. They are our mirror. With them, we know what our potential is. Without them, we're only propped up ego recycling minor successes ad infinitum. Danger at last. The emotional tone in danger, surprisingly, is where you're wondering, you're conservative, you have mild interest in things, you have concerns, and you have mild anxiety about those concerns and that interest and that wondering, but it's only mild anxiety. Your attitude is curiosity. This is what compels you to act. You're curious. You're willing to open up and learn new things and, again, wonder about the world. The problem recognition is that you're being lured into a dangerous situation where you're going to have to be fully present, and you care. That's what makes it dangerous. You care. You have some investment in this project that you're working on. Maybe it's a love life. Who knows? The recognition of other roles is discovery. People want to discover you. You want to discover them. How to move up. Recognize any detrimental elements and handle it. Ensure ethical behavior. Ethics, by the way, coined by Aristotle, 500 BC, is made up of three components: character, intelligence, and goodwill. As long as you have all three operating, don't forget the goodwill. Character and intelligence without goodwill could be a monster, a very smart monster. But with goodwill, meaning you will always feel good toward others and never against them, you are ethical. uh-oh, someone or something has actually got us interested in walking unfamiliar territory, and it is a different kind of scary. More like a fun kind of scary, jittery in the heart somewhere, triggering healthy curiosity, slight anxiety because we cannot control this kind of synergy. We have to become unstable to go through the change occurring here. This is where everything we have learned about trusting ourselves comes into play. Because in order to trust the lure and make the discovery of another, we've got to let go of our ego fears and don the spirit of adventure. The danger is not like the danger in the pits. It is more like taking on something unfamiliar and flying with it. We can handle it. Emergency. The emotional tone in emergency is empathy and strong interest. A lot of people in our world today have been so badly conditioned that they can't empathize with others. Empathize means you can stand in the shoes of another and feel their feelings given what they're going through. In emergency, you learn to empathy and you become strongly interested in others. Your attitude is amusement, liking, satisfaction, and you have expectations. The problem is challenges. Yep, life is full of challenges. And you see others as cooperating with you for a change. How to move up? Economize, prepare, stiffen your integrity. Yikes, green light, we are now on a roll. We are falling in love, becoming substantial in our self-concepts, feeling capable of challenges, and see others as wanting to cooperate in our growth. What a wonderful place to be. Finally, to be in a place where all of the excitement, all of the energy is geared toward evolution, not revolution, not holding back, not blaming, shaming, begging for credit, asking for praise, or avoiding guilt. This is good stuff. More to come. We haven't yet reached that beautiful state in which we were born, that state called normal. But it is coming soon. The state of integrity, this state of integrity, emergency, grooms us for developing insights, for seeing the bigger picture outside the box. Normal, finally at last normal. The emotional tone in normal is enthusiasm and cheerfulness. Look at children, look at 2 years old. Look at the people that haven't been damaged yet. They're full of enthusiasm, they're full of cheerfulness. And it's not necessarily the rich that are enthusiastic and cheerful. They're bad and good in all economic states of being. This is self-development. Integrity is a personal choice. You have an attitude of enthusiasm, admiration, you're not afraid to admire others without being jealous of them or wanting to tear them down. You're cheerful. You can be trusted to be around. Your problem recognition is opportunity. All kinds of opportunities start popping up. And the recognition of others' roles are enhancement. They want to make you grow. They want to help you grow. At one time, this was normal in America. We need to get it back. How to move up. Strengthen positive results. Adjust for any diminished results. Ignorance may be bliss, but innocence is where it's at. We at Noodle Brain say that you cannot be innocent until you are awake enough to have a choice, and then choose things that make a difference in the quality of our lives. From birth, we see everything and everyone as an opportunity to enhance our lives. Babies and children up to 2 are cheerful and enthusiastic, providing they have not been damaged by docile servile imprinting intended to keep them quiet and still. That kind of imprinting starts our journey into the lower states of integrity. We must humor our children and allow them their narcissism, distracting them from harm rather than shutting them down. Then they will more likely be functional adults. In the meantime, strengthen positive results. Abundance. The emotional tone is exhilaration and aesthetics. Aesthetics, look it up. Look up exhilaration too. Exhilaration is really being happy, and aesthetic means having a quality of life that is distinct from the horrors that are possible. Attitude, gratefulness, cherishing, ardor, enchantment. Look up those words. Write about them in your journal. The problem is welcome. That's not really a problem, is it? But you're welcome and you welcome others. The recognition of others is they're devoted to you. They're absolutely devoted to your growth. How to move up? Economize, Study for even more. Strengthen elements that cause abundance. Got endorphins? If we didn't have them before this, we feel them now. Endorphins are the faith-producing hormone released when we know we make a difference. We welcome others, and others are devoted to our goals. We're grateful, exhilarated, just really kitschy-peen as the ambulances go off outside my window. There is nothing like this natural high, and whatever we did to get here imprints this possibility for us for the rest of our lives. We have more than enough and economize to focus our efforts freely. We've stretched beyond childhood in a most positive and healthy way. From here, we can raise our children and manage our civic duties with some clout. Power source, the top of the ladder. The emotional tone as a power source is serenity of beingness. This stuff is worth working toward. Games and action. Your attitude is serenity, ecstasy, joy, compassion. Your problem recognition is liberty. You finally know what having liberty and freedom is all about and why America is so important. The recognition of others' roles is trust and faith. Let me tell you, faith, the distinction between faith and hope are enormous. Hope is like hanging on by the edge of your fingernails and pleading others to please notice what's going on and having hope that they might. Faith is having reached certainty that you are intentional about this so much that your faith is invested in it and you will make it happen, whatever it is. How to move up. Expand your responsibilities and increase your integrity. Responsibility is not blame, shame, credit, praise, or guilt. Remember that. It is the willingness to be cause in the matter for ourselves and for others. When in positions of power, we have the potential for life to be a joyful event. When we do, we experience the distinction between power and what poses as power, force. Being wealthy may offer liberties without the attitudes generated by a genuine power source. Wealth can buy force, but it cannot buy serenity, ecstasy, joy, and compassion. We don't have to be wealthy to be a power source. We have only to take responsibility for our power and be a source for joy for others to experience this peace. You can be wealthy if you want to be wealthy. If you clear yourself this far, you probably will become wealthy because you will create something that everyone wants and needs and naturally make money out of it. It will have nothing to do with greed and nothing to do with disloyalty and nothing to do with being adversarial toward others and nothing to do with uncertainty or actually climbing up the scale from number 8 to from 1 to 8. Actually from 8 to 1. Anyway, get yourself around this and have a good life. Thank you for this opportunity to be of service.